ahora sí, ha llegado la hora de mandarlos con la entrevista que tuve la oportunidad de hacer esta tarde con Blink-182, una entrevista totalmente en exclusiva para Telehit, ningún otro canal latinoamericano tuvo la oportunidad de entrevistarlos frente a frente, y vamos a ver qué les parece. Nosotros vamos a continuar con más, ¿no le cambia? Carnales, y bueno, seguimos aquí en México, Distrito Federal, y tenemos el gran honor de tener a nuestro lado y poder platicar con Tom, Travis y Mark, Blink-182. Thank you very much for having this interview. And first question, your actual single here in Mexico, I Miss You, what do you want to express with that song, with that particular song?
No, I don't think there's a specific thing to express. For us, it's just like which is a little art piece that we did that we worked on. Like, we tried to make a different song of other than all the things that we've done in our past. We wanted it to be unique. We wanted it to showcase just a whole different style of music that our band can do and likes to do. And I don't know, it's kind of got an 80s sensibility to it too, where we all grew up obviously in the 80s. So, but there's no thing that we're trying to.
Le estaba preguntando acerca de su primer, bueno, su sencillo más reciente, segundo sencillo, diciendo que ellos realmente no tratan de expresar nada en concreto, ¿no? Que ellos simplemente trataron de hacer una rola diferente a las que la gente estaba acostumbrada a escuchar de Blink-182, que tiene un poquito de vibra de los 80s, porque fue, bueno, obviamente la etapa en donde ellos crecieron, por ahí de los 80s. And with this album, you change your way to make music, not you change the sound, you change the lyrics. I like a lot, but why do you decide to make that change?
Well, I think we're just getting ready to push ourselves. I think that we've had these ideas for a while, but we just really took the time on this album to do it. It took a year almost to record this album, and we changed everything about the way that we wrote songs, recorded them, everything. I mean, we would go in and work on half of a song one day, half of a song a different day, go back and work on the first song. We'd try all these different things. We'd take songs, have them completely written and recorded, and then change those songs. And I don't know, it just really gave us a chance to treat the studio more like a musical laboratory. And it just made writing music fun again, you know? I think that at the end of the touring for Take Off Your Pants and Jacket, I think that we were feeling stale as a band, that we needed to try and do some different stuff, and so that's why.
Bueno, le estaba preguntando acerca del cambio musical con este nuevo material discográfico a lo que nos tenían acostumbrados. Ellos dicen que sí, que ellos hicieron un cambio, que ellos ya necesitaban hacer este cambio, que de hecho desde la forma en grabar las rolas fue diferente, que de repente grababan la mitad de la rola en un día y después, bueno, se esperaban al día siguiente para hacerla, y que básicamente después del tour de Take Off Your Pants and Jacket, ellos ya se sentían pues un poco cansados y querían realmente hacer otra cosa, ¿no? Y utilizar el estudio como un laboratorio musical, ¿no? Lo cual es bastante interesante. And how was the first time that you get in touch with punk music?
Well, I think we're all kids. Probably all of us were in about junior high school or so, and we all got exposed to it different ways. You know, we Travis and I are from Southern California. Mark's kind of lived a few places across the states, but in California, that kind of music's really big. In Southern California, it's almost a part of your life for most people that grew up in that area. But also, you know, we all kind of grew up skateboarding, and it's like, it's just a culture. I don't know. It's weird. You grow up with these people that you identify with, and it's just a part of you to be, you know, near that kind of music, I guess. And I don't know. I remember being in seventh grade and hearing it for the first time, and I was so happy to hear something that I could relate to, that had an energy that not everyone knew about, that was like this special, cool little thing, you know, that it just made me feel at home. That's all I can say.
Les estaba preguntando acerca de la primera vez que tuvieron contacto con la música punk. Ellos dicen que fue más o menos como cuando estaban en secundaria, porque en el sur de California este tipo de música, pues bueno, es un ambiente muy grande, hay muchísimos seguidores. Entonces, bueno, ellos también les gustaba patinar, y es una cultura, ¿no?, que se maneja el punk con el skate, de repente también con el surf, y son cosas que, bueno, ellos les gustaba ese tipo de música porque era una música que no era tan conocida y que aparte pues era poderosa, ¿no? And talking about when you were kids, do you remember like the most memorable party that you were when you were in high school?
When I was in high school, I lived out in the middle of the desert, and so what we used to do is we had a few spots out in the desert where everyone from the high school would go, and there'd be parties out in the middle of the desert, and everyone would park their cars in kind of a circle and turn on their headlights, and there'd be kegs of beer, and so those are the parties that I remember from high school, is being out in the middle of the desert, and there were always fights, and oh yeah. Yeah, That, those are the parties that I remember.
Bueno, nos estaba platicando acerca de las fiestas que se acuerdan cuando estaban en prepa. Que bueno, Mark, él vivía rodeado de desierto, ¿no? Entonces ellos lo que hacían, todos los brothers se juntaban, se iban al desierto, ponían sus coches para que sirviera de iluminación y que había peleas, había chupe, etcétera, etcétera. Lo que sucede en cualquier fiesta y que, bueno, son de las fiestas que más se acuerdan. And Travis, can you, well, talking about when you were a kid, can you describe a little bit how was your room, your bedroom, when you lived with your parents? Did you have, like, posters or did you collect something?
It was on my wall and, like my favorite bands, like Slayer and Sepultura. Like, I just knew a lot of metal when I was a kid, like Run DMC. I just decorated my room with, like, skateboarding and music, you know, and drums. I had a drum set in my room. So that's all I did all day is play drums, you know.
Bueno, él estaba preguntando a Travis que nos describiera un poquito cómo era su cuarto cuando él estaba más chavo, cuando él vivía con sus papás. Él dice que, bueno, tenía póster de patinetas, póster de sus bandas favoritas como Slayer, buena banda, Pantera también, que él de chavito le gustaba oír mucho, pues, metal, y bueno, que tenía también muchas set de baterías, porque igual él desde muy chavito empezó a tocar la bataca, y entonces, bueno, pues, de esa manera como que se sentía más a gusto. And right now, Travis, you're working with a lot of different bands, with Black Eyed Peas, with Bob Sparks, with Boxcar Racer, with the Transplants. Do you have any plans to do something else? Do you remember, well, I know you remember the Aquabats, the Fury of the Aquabats.
Yeah, that band, like, it was cool.
Do you have any plans to do something with the Aquabats again?
I don't know. I mean, if we did, like, a reunion show or something fun, it would be cool, but other than that, like with my broken foot and everything else, I'm just trying to get through this Blink tour and do a Transplants record. So that's the only thing I'm looking forward to. And we're going to do some recording. Like, we're thinking about doing like an EP or something just to keep things exciting and stuff, because we're so excited to write music again. You know what I mean? It feels like we have like a growth spurt in our band where we need to, like, you know, I don't know, get some stuff out, write some songs.
Yo le estaba preguntando que si él tenía pensado alguna reunión con The Aquabats, que era la banda que tenía antes de Blink-182. Dice que ahorita, pues no tiene mucho tiempo, a menos que fuera una especie como de reencuentro así para tocar algunos toquines leves, pero que él está concentrado en hacer nuevo disco de Transplants y obviamente pues toda la gira con Blink-182. Y pues a ver si utiliza otra vez su nickname de Travis Von... How was it?
Baron Von Tito. Yeah, absolutely.
And Mark, also, when you, before the Blink-182, you originally wanted to be a high school teacher, right? Why?
I've always loved to read, and when I was in high school, I had a really cool teacher that taught literature, but it wasn't about you read a book and then you answer questions about the book. It was like he made you interested in why the book was written and how it was written and what the characters did. And it wasn't about remembering certain scenes of the book. It was about understanding the book. And I don't know, it made me really appreciate that in teachers, like someone that could actually inspire kids to want to learn. And so many teachers, they just want you to be able to remember the certain things for the test. And that's not what teaching is really about. Teaching is really about opening doors for people and making them understand things. And it's not just about memorizing a bunch of facts, you know? So that really inspired me, and that's what I wanted to do.
Bueno, le pregunté que antes de entrar a Blink-182, Mark, le hubiera gustado ser profesor de una prepa de clase de literatura. Y él nos dice que sí, que porque tenía una maestra que pues era muy chida, que no era así de que te tienes que aprender de memoria esto y lo tienes que decir, sino más bien les daba la libertad como de que, bueno, léanlo ustedes, reflexionenlo, y que así es como debe de ser la enseñanza, según Mark. Entonces sí, él estaba interesado en ser profesor, pero bueno, pues salió la banda y pues ya, le fue mejor, ¿no? And Tom, you really believe, I believe too, in aliens, right?
Well, I believe that there's other things out there in the universe. It's one of those weird things. I think when you're a musician, you have a lot of time to sit around and think about weird things like that. Think about the world. You see a lot of the world, and that's, I don't know, I'm into that. I think one of the most beautiful times of the day is at night when you can see all the stars. God, I mean, it must be fascinating to be an astronaut and go to the moon and realize how tiny and insignificant the Earth is in comparison to the whole universe.
Yeah, because it's kind of selfish to say, no, we're the only one in the universe.
Yeah, you know, and they're talking about finding life on Mars right now, and that's one planet away. So I think I think the future's going to be really interesting for science, you know, and that, I like science, I'm into it.
It's weird.
Le estaba platicando acerca y le estaba preguntando acerca de su fascinación por los aliens, que yo también, por los extraterrestres, que yo también creo. Él dice que sí, que de repente cuando eres rockero tienes mucho tiempo para pensar todo tipo de cosas, ¿no? Entonces, él siempre ha pensado que es una manera egoísta el pensar que en el universo nada más existe vida en la Tierra, ¿no? Entonces, qué mejor y qué mejor parte del día, bueno, parte de todo un día, que es la noche, ¿no? Que es cuando tú te puedes sentar, ver las estrellas, y chido también pues, poder ser astronauta, ¿no? And another thing about Blink 182 is the tattoos. You don't have any tattoos, right?
No, I have tattoos.
You have tattoos?
Yeah. Travis got them for me while we were recording the Blink album. I have my wife's name on my left wrist and my son's name on my right wrist.
I didn't see it, sorry.
He's got my name on his lower back.
I don't really. With an arrow or something. And what is like the first and the last tattoo you have?
First tattoo I have is this bunny, which is the old logo of Blink 182.
Yeah.
And then the last tattoo I have is my wife's name on the back of my neck.
Wow. Estamos platicando acerca de tatuajes, que de hecho Mark ya tiene también tatuado el nombre de su chava, tiene tatuado aquí en las muñecas. Y bueno, Tom, su primer tatuaje fue un pequeño conejo que antes era el logo de Blink 182. Y el último que se hizo fue el nombre de su esposa aquí.
What about you, Travis? My first one is covered up because of my cast and stuff. The last one I got was my Marilyn Monroe on my neck and this writing on my wrist, my son's name.
Bueno, pues nos está platicando también de sus primeros. El primer tatuaje no se puede ver porque lo tiene donde está el yeso, pero también, bueno, tiene aquí un Marilyn Monroe y tiene también aquí un hombre tatuado aquí. Do you like Nightmare Before Christmas?
Yeah, I love it. I love it. I'm actually having I'm getting married in October and our whole wedding is like themed Nightmare Before Christmas, like with pumpkins.
Oh,
Christmas
really?
Lights. Yeah.
Cool. Bueno, le estaba platicando, él le gusta mucho la película del extraño mundo de Jack o Nightmare Before Christmas y dice que de hecho su boda va a ser con motivos, pues onda como de calabazas y onda también, bueno, referente a la película de Nightmare Before Christmas. And another thing, yesterday you went in Monterrey, how was it? How do you feel the Mexican crowd?
It was amazing for me. It was awesome. The kids are great. I was telling them, we were telling some people earlier too, is we live in San Diego or Southern California, they live in Los Angeles, but there's a huge Mexican population there. It feels like we're at home here. It really does. And more so than probably any other country across the world because we live in California. But the kids were amazing and the show was amazing and we were mediocre.
Why?
No, I know we were good. We're always good. Come on, man. You can't get any better than a Blink show, right?
No, it's right. It's right. Bueno, le estaba preguntando acerca del toquín de ayer en Monterrey. Me está diciendo que pues les fue muy bien, que se acuerda mucho de la banda donde él creció, porque bueno, todos son de San Diego, entonces ahí es muy similar la gente a cómo se vive aquí en México. Entonces, pues que la neta se la pasaron bastante, bastante chido y que bueno, obviamente la gente estuvo increíble cantando todas sus rolas, etcétera, etcétera. And you have a song. I'm a really The Cure fan, really, really big The Cure fan. How was your experience to work with Robert Smith?
Awesome. We're gigantic fans of The Cure, and we wrote this song, and it reminded us of a Cure song, and so we made some phone calls to see if he wanted to collaborate with us on that song, and he was interested, and so he recorded his vocals and wrote his vocal parts, and I don't know, to have him on our record is a dream come true for us. We're really stoked.
Le estaba preguntando acerca de la rola que tienen junto con Robert Smith, que de hecho se llama, por aquí dice, All of This, right?
Yeah.
La rola de All of This que tiene junto con Robert Smith. Dicen que, bueno, ellos también siempre han sido muy fans de The Cure, que le echaron un telefonazo y que afortunadamente Robert Smith accedió, grabó las voces y que fue increíble porque le metieron una vibrita de The Cure que, bueno, o sea, obviamente a todos nos gusta. Okay, last question because we gotta go. I know that you are a porno fan and I'm a porno fan too. So,
yes.
What is like your favorite of each one of you? What's your favorite porn movie and your favorite porn actress? I like Janine, the one that is an animal to say.
I think we're all big fans of Janine. You know who's really, really hot is, have you seen Ron Jeremy?
He's Ron,
great.
Ron Jeremy is like the guy.
He's like a troll.
he had the word that everybody would like.
Right? Yeah, but he's gross. But, I think, we're all fans of Janine. I mean, we're not, you know, I don't know if we're all going to start naming people off right now that we're that into, but I think what's cool about Janine, besides working with Blink, is that she only does movies with women.
Yeah.
And that there is something there that is very attractive.
Yeah, I like that too. It's better, right?
It's better.
What's your like your favorite porn? I like also Jaina Jameson. She's hot.
No,
she's hot.
No, she's not.
Well, she's old, but at the time she was
hot. No, it's not that she's old. She's like a
she's good.
Before she got.
Yeah, of course. Gentile, she's beautiful. Yeah. She's beautiful. And this one that she was like 16 and she...
Oh, that's illegal. Why are you bringing up shit that's illegal?
No, but she was like really famous because nobody knows that she was underage after like 2 years. But I don't know the name. But she's hot. Bueno, estamos hablando de porno, ¿no, carnales? Y nos estaban platicando de sus películas favoritas. Por ejemplo, Tom nos dice de Janine, una actriz porno muy conocida que sale en el cover de Enemy of the State de su material discográfico. Algo que es muy interesante es que ella nada más hace películas con mujeres, lo cual nos da bastante gusto. Y hablando un poquito de Ron Jeremy, que era así como que el maestro de la pornografía ochentera, pues también que pues el güey le echaba ganas y que tenía una chamba pues bastante, bastante chida. Ok, thank you very much for that. This interview. Anything you want to say to all of your fans in Latin America, not just in Mexico City, but in all Latin America?
We'd love to say that we will be there soon. We had so much fun at the first show in Mexico, and we expect to have the most amazing time here in Mexico City, but we can't wait to go to places all over South America. So hopefully we will see them soon, and we will be there.
Pues bueno, toda la banda que no es de aquí de México, sino es de toda Latinoamérica y que está viendo esta entrevista, pues que no se preocupen. Tom les dice que van a hacer todo lo posible porque Blink-182 esté próximamente en su país, que la gente los ha tratado increíble en Latinoamérica. Entonces, pues ellos están muy contentos con este tour y que esperan poder hacerlo en un futuro no muy lejano, pues un poquito más grande y que llegue a otros países.
Thank you very much for that. This interview.
Nice to meet you, man. Cool. Thank you, man. Pues bueno, vamos a continuar con más, carnales. No le muevan. Estamos aquí en Telehit.